faster rate. So this is letting that shine come through. This is what's giving you that youthful appearance after you exfoliate. And you just want it in gentle circles, light circles. We don't want to be too rough on the skin. Now, I see a lot of recipes for sugar scrubs. It's not the healthiest thing for your face. I've seen a lot of recipes for salt scrubs. Again, it's not the healthiest thing for your face. So if you want to DIY your own exfoliator, it could be just as simple as a little drizzle of the orange blossom facial wash, take just a pinch of baking soda, and you can get an exfoliation out of that. The Snap Mint facial scrub really is perfection. And I say, don't mess with perfection. If you want to make your own DIY facial scrub, one of the most amazing ones you can do is take the frankincense resin, grind those up, add just a dropper of this beauty serum, and use that as an exfoliator. It's incredible. How many of you have tried that? How many of you are excited to finally know what to do with your resins?
I know.
Because I just sit in that bag, and you maybe take them out at Christmas and put them by your nativity set. Best use I've come up with so far, right? Now you can make a facial scrub out of them. So after you exfoliate your face, what happens is you drop the pH of your skin, and we want to get that pH back up. Before you put on any makeup at this point, or any moisturizers or anything else, we want to get the pH of the skin back where it belongs. How many of you struggle with a skin imbalance, like maybe oily skin or skin that's too dry? It's really as simple as just balancing the pH on the skin once again. So we do that with the toner. So after you exfoliate, we want to get the pH of the skin back where it belongs, and you do that with the toner. So we're going to take the toner here in the sample packet. How many of you have attended beauty school, young women? How many of you then just ordered the beauty box, the sampler? Smartest thing you could have done, get that beauty box. You can only get it if you've gone to beauty school. So what I just did is I offered to my team. I wanted to test it. I test things on my team before I tell you guys about it. Because then if it doesn't work, I've only messed myself up. I haven't messed all of you up. I use my team as a guinea pig. And 9 times out of 10, it works out right. So one of the things that I just did is I bought about 50 beauty school boxes and then broke these up into individuals, charged them my cost into it, so $17. Then I mailed them the samples, and we're gonna do a Facebook Live beauty school. They're going to do the products with me in real time, watching it. It's kind of like the cooking shows where you should cook along with it, right? How many of you are going, shoot, I should have ordered more beauty boxes? So 225 people on my team are gonna go through this next week. So we have the turnaround? Perfect, we're set. So now you basically have a clean slate on your face. Anything you put on your skin at this point is going to absorb in all those nutrients, all those molecules. So when we go from lightest viscosity to thickest viscosity. So what are some of the lightest viscosity things you can put on your face at this point? Your essential oils. So after I put on the toner, that's when I like to take 2 drops of frankincense and a drop of patchouli. How many of you have done this? You've heard me talk about it. It's like a layer of silk on your skin, isn't it pretty? It's amazing. How many of you are excited you finally know what to do with your patchouli? Because that comes out like once you're in, you think, should I use it? What should I do with this? And you put it back. Now you're gonna burn right through it. So I take 2 drops of frankincense, 1 drop of patchouli, I dampen my fingers with the running water, and I just put that all over, and everything just absorbs in so nicely. You guys, that has been the game changer for my oily skin. That has just really helped to reset everything, and I don't struggle with oily skin anymore. So after we have the oils on, we go to the next lightest viscosity. So we're going to do the Orchid Renewal Serum. How many of you have used this? There is a chemical compound in the orchid petals, hyaluronic acid, and it has the ability to hold 10 times its weight in moisture. 10 times its weight in moisture. Ladies, we can't eliminate wrinkles. Unless you're gonna get Botox or die young, you cannot eliminate wrinkles. They are a part of what we are as we age, but you can reduce the appearance of them. And you do that by hydrating the skin and hydrating your body. Make sure you're drinking enough water through the day. But when we can take the Arbutin serum, get that into the skin, help the skin hold 10 times its weight in moisture, but it's so light, right? We need to hold and lock that moisture in. So immediately after we put the serum on, we want to take the Art Light moisturizer, and we want to get that on your face. That's going to hold that hydration in. Now, how many of you wear mineral makeup? We want to make sure that you have a flawless complexion when you're wearing mineral makeup, and sometimes it can look like the minerals sit topical, and that's why a lot of people are afraid to try mineral makeup. We want to prime the face first, and I promised you I would share the two products that help you prime your face for mineral makeup wear. It's these two things right here, the Renewal Serum and the Art Light Moisturizer. So once you have those on, within about 3 to 5 minutes, you want to start putting your mineral makeup on. And that's just going to help you get that flawless look and that flawless appearance, especially when you put the mineral makeup on using a misted method, using the lavender spray. I'm pretty sure I'm the reason why it's always out of stock. Okay, so lightest viscosity to thickest viscosity with the moisturizers. How many of you are afraid to moisturize your face because your face gets oily or you get breakouts and moisturizers just feel too thick? We want to make sure that you're using the right moisturizer. So when I teach beauty school, I let them sample each of the moisturizers so they can feel how they are on their face to be able to determine and gauge which one works best for their skin. So the Art Light moisturizer is the lightest viscosity of the moisturizers. Then we have the Boswellia Wrinkle Cream. The next one on your spoon. I like to use this in targeted areas, not all over my face. It's too thick. There was a young lady that was talking to me this morning, and she said she's afraid to put any moisturizers on because her skin will break out and her skin needs to breathe. So I was excited for her to hear this presentation so she knows the right ones to use. I know that so many of you love sandalwood as an all-over moisturizer. So if you were going to teach a beauty school, you would only talk about sandalwood. If I would put sandalwood on my face, I'd break out the next day. It's too thick for my skin. So if you're going to do a beauty school and have someone only try sandalwood and they break out from it or their skin is too much, what have you just given them an impression and a feeling of the skincare line? So make sure that you're trying all of them yourself so you know how they feel on the skin and give them the opportunity to try them out as well. There are three areas on our body that age us the quickest. Does anyone know where they are? Your face, the back of your hands, your décolleté, your cleavage. So we want to make sure that we don't forget these areas either. So when I use the Boswellia Wrinkle Cream, I like to go under the eyes, the back of my hands, and my chest area. It's too thick for all over my face. It smells incredible. The aroma of that one is amazing. And then the last one is Sandalwood Moisturizing Cream. And I like to use that on my elbows, on my knees, on my feet. In the winter, sometimes I get really dry around here. Just use it to touch up on those areas. How many of you just had a lot of confusion eliminated on how to exfoliate? Does this seem like a doable routine? Okay, let's talk one. That's great. She's gonna start the routine. Okay, so the days that we don't exfoliate, we want to demoisturize. So So we're gonna start with cleansing the face. So I'm gonna show you how to use the Orange Blossom Facial Wash. I love it. It is great for sensitive skin, for skin that gets easily irritated, maybe skin that has a little bit of redness, because it's so soothing and it helps to calm that irritated skin. That wolfberry seed extract just helps to calm that irritated skin. And the citrus oils that are in it are gonna help dull, or brighten that dull complexion. So over winter, especially from the northern states and we don't get as much sun and our complexion just looks a little dull, Orange Blossom Facial Wash is incredible. But that one bottle, you can burn through that in 30 days. Can I share with you a tip on how to make it last about 6 months? Okay. So we're going to take what's in this packet, put it in here, fill the rest with water, and there you go. You've diluted it down, it's a funky hand. And I like taking these for travel, and if I put my Orange Blossom Facial Wash in it, and then throw it in my bag, it's not gonna count as a liquid. And I've just eliminated that, so I'm just going to travel to. Then when I get to my hotel, I find that most hotels that I stay at have water. There was one questionable hotel on the Australian tour. So now I can say most hotels have water. So then I fill it up when I'm at the hotel and I'm good to go. So then ladies will wash, you got that? All the muscles, all of them. There you go. So after you get that filled up, give it a little shake and go ahead and wash your face. The other cleansers that Yum Yummy has, the Art Cleanser, it's ideal for more mature skin or skin that's a little bit dry. So if you have people with oily skin, this is gonna be a little bit too moisturizing for them. So give them the opportunity to do the Orange Blossom Facial Wash. Now, I like doing some of these make and take little things during beauty school so that people can see how easy it is to make this stuff. They can see how easy it is to incorporate. They can even enhance that and add some frankincense. Maybe add a few drops of Melrose. Maybe some rosemary and geranium.